गुड मॉर्निंग, अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। सो एज़ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द रीडिंग ऑफ यूनिट 17, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द एक्सरसाइजेस। सो क्विकली टेक आउट द स्टूडेंट बुक एंड ओपन द पेज नंबर 168। हियर यू मे सी एक्सरसाइज बी, वी हैव टू सर्कल द करेक्ट ऑप्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू द सेंटेंस। I am reading sentence number 1. It can be very hot near this part of the world. So, if you remember that tundra and taiga was the coldest biome on earth. So, the correct option is tropical rainforest. Kindly circle the option tropical rainforest. Sentence 2. You can find this in a very dry part of the world. So the given options are temperate forest and desert. So according to you, what can be the dry part of the world? Of course, it's desert. So circle the option desert. Sentence 2. Now come to the sentence number 3. This part of the world is usually cold. And the options are grassland and taiga. And I told you before that taiga and tundra are the coldest parts of the world. So the correct option is taiga. Circle taiga in sentence number 3. Sentence number 4. Many farmers want to be near this biome. So farmer basically is a person who has a farm. So given options are desert and freshwater. So I think nobody wants to be near to the biome of a desert. So the correct option is freshwater. Circle freshwater in sentence 4. Sentence 5. This place has many trees. So if you remember that in the grassland biome, there were no a single tree. So the correct option is temperate forest. Circle temperate forest in the sentence number 5. Come to the exercise C. Complete the sentences with the following words. We have 4 words and we have to fill the each blank with the correct word. Words are sloth. Sloth is an animal. Biome. It's a area in which the plants and animals live together. Cactus is a plant. Equator. Equator is an imaginary line around the middle of the planet. Fine, so let's read the sentence. A rainforest is a dish near the dish. So what is the rainforest? Is it an animal or plant? It's a biome. So write down in the first blank biome. A rainforest is a biome near the equator. In the second blank, write down equator. A rainforest is a biome near the equator. It's a good home for a dish, but it's not a good home for a dish. So do you remember that in the rainforest, tropical rainforest biome, the animals that were living, the names are monkeys, spider monkeys, sloth, and jaguars. So the blank number 3 is sloth. It's a good home for a sloth, but it's not a good home for a cactus. Blank 1 is biome. Blank 2 equator. Blank 3 sloth. Blank 4 cactus. Let's move to the other exercise. on the page number 169, exercise D, classify and categorize. So what is classify and categorize? So what is the difference between the categorize and classify? In the categorize, we just categorize the animals, like animals or any object. Like if I ask you that, tell me the names of the big animals, so all of you will start taking the names like elephant, giraffe, camels and so on. So elephant, giraffe and camel, these animals do not belong to a same group, but we just categorize them in a same group. Now we categorize them in a same group, and the group is what? The name of the group is big. I asked you that, tell me the name of the big animals, and you just started to tell me these names. Fine. So categorize is that we categorize the same thing or almost same thing, same objects. Fine. First we categorize them, then we put them into a class. Classify means we give the title of the of that category. We give name of that group, like these animals were having the name what? Big animals. Like this we categorize the animals and the objects. So I'm reading the definition which is written on the book. So look at the page number 169, exercise D. Remember, you can classify and categorize information to help you understand it better. So why do we categorize? We categorize the objects for the better understanding. To categorize, gather pieces of information that are the same or the almost the same into a group means they belongs to a same group or almost the same group. And to classify, give that group a name that I have already defined to you, that in the classify we just give the title of the group. Fine. Now I'm going to read the paragraph, so listen to me very carefully. Ocean and freshwater biomes are home to many kinds of fish. Now ocean and freshwater, these are the biomes, and these two biomes are home for many kind of fishes. Fine. Now let's see, in the ocean which kinds of fishes are there? Ocean fish such as the swordfish and the shark can be very big. Now in the ocean, what kind of fishes are there? Like swordfish and the shark, and these are the big fishes. Fine. Whales in the ocean can be huge. Now whale is even the biggest, but they are not fish. But whale is not a fish. Whale is the biggest and huge, but it's not fish. Only swordfish and the shark are fishes that are the big in the ocean category of the water. So let's read about the freshwater fish. Freshwater fish such as sunfish and freshwater trout are usually smaller. Now in the freshwater, sunfish and the freshwater trout, these are the smaller fishes. However, the carp is a freshwater fish. Now the carp is also a freshwater fish that can grow to be quite big. Now freshwater fish carp can also grow big. So start writing the categories of the fishes into the correct box, into the correct column. The options are given like whale, carp, swordfish, sunfish, shark, trout. Start writing the ocean animal. The first name is swordfish. second is shark, third is whale. Ocean animal, swordfish, shark, whale. Now write down the freshwater animal. Number 1, sunfish. Number 2, trout. Freshwater animal, sunfish and trout. Now in the category of bag, start writing. Number 1, swordfish. Number 2, shark. Number 3, whale. Number 4, carp. Write down the small category. Start writing. Number 1, sunfish. Number 2, trout. And in the category not a fish, there is only one. Write down whale. Now take out the workbook and open the page number 155. Exercise B. Again we have to circle the correct word. I am reading sentence number 1. The tundra / grassland biome is always frozen. Now which biome was frozen? It was tundra. So circle tundra in the sentence 1. Sentence 2. A sloth / cactus lives easily without much water. Sloth is animal. Fine. And it needs water to survive. So cactus is correct option. Circle cactus in the sentence 2. Sentence 3. The temperate / taiga biome has evergreen trees. Now if you remember that in the taiga forest biome, this forest was full of with evergreen trees. So correct option is taiga. Circle taiga in the sentence number 3. Sentence 4. A desert / tropical rainforest is the driest biome on earth. And we all know that the desert is the driest biome on earth. So circle desert in the sentence 4. Sentence 5. There may be new medicines to be discovered in a tropical rainforest / sloth. Read the sentence again. There may be new medicines to be discovered in a dish. Now when we say in a, it means we are talking about a place. And what place is here? Sloth is animal, so the place is tropical rainforest. Circle tropical rainforest in the sentence number 5. And the last sentence is, you might find a zebra or a rhinoceros in the dish. Number 1 option is grassland. Number 2 option is temperate forest. Now zebra and rhinoceros, they both live in the grassland biome. So circle grassland in the sentence number 6. Circle all the options carefully and then move to the next exercise. Exercise C on the same page. So there are some pair words like desert cactuses, freshwater biomes, taiga temperate forest, tundra equator, tropical rainforest, sloth. We have to be very careful while filling these pair of the words into the sentences. Desert and cactuses will be filled into a same sentence, each sentence having the two blanks, and each of the pair will be filled in the inner sentence. Fine. So let's start with the sentence number 1. If you hike through a dish, You may see a dish hanging quietly from a tree branch. Now, if you read the words again, the pair of the words, you may see that there is only one pair of word that has animal name given, that is the sloth. So in the sentence number one, pair tropical rainforest and sloth will be filled. Start writing. In the blank one, sentence one, tropical rainforest. Blank two, sentence one, sloth. If you hike through a tropical rainforest, you may see a sloth hanging quietly from a tree branch. I am reading sentence number two now. Both the ocean and dish are water, dish, but the ocean is much larger. Now, what the water is, water pair is in the box. It is the fresh water. So start writing fresh water in the sentence number two. Both the ocean and fresh water are water biomes, but the ocean is the much larger. Sentence three. A dry dish may have dish that are up to 20 meters tall. A dry desert. Start writing pear, desert and cactuses. A dry desert may have cactuses that are up to 20 meters tall. Number four, the cold dish is far from the dish which is around the middle of earth. Start writing blank one tundra and blank two equator. Sentence number four, the cold tundra is far from the equator which is around the middle of earth. Come to the last sentence. Tree loving squirrels can be found in the both the dish and the dish. Now only one pair of the words is left, that is what? Taiga and temperate forest. So in the blank, in the first blank, write down taiga. Tree-loving squirrels can be found in both the taiga and the temperate forest. In the second blank, write down temperate forest. Fill the blanks carefully. Your writing should be neat and clean. So that's all for today. Take a very good care of yourself. Have a good day. Allah Hafiz.